Equilibrium occurs where quantity supplied equals quantity demanded. What does it mean? Basically, your market price will be stable, that is, it won't tend to change, when you reach the point at which willingness to buy coincides with willingness to sell in the market. Here's a numerical example. Note that I could pick any numbers for my demand as long as I follow one simple rule. As price goes up, quantity demanded must go down. That's the law of demand. Similarly for supply, as price goes up, quantity supplied must go up as well to follow the law of supply. Without even looking at a diagram, where is equilibrium? Equilibrium occurs at a price of $3 where the quantity demanded equals the quantity supplied at 3 units. Please note that the fact that price and quantity are both 3 is just a coincidence. They will not always be the same. If I plot out these numbers, first the demand figures, then supply, I reach the same conclusion with the diagram. Equilibrium occurs at a price of $3 where the quantity supplied equals the quantity demanded at 3 units. Why is this the equilibrium? Because no other price would be stable. All other prices would have a tendency to change. At a dollar, for instance, the buyers are happy. They'd love to buy 5 units, but the sellers are unhappy. They're only willing to provide 1 unit to the market. A situation like this, where the quantity demanded is greater than the quantity supplied, is referred to as a shortage and will result in upward pressure on price. Why? Well, those buyers all want to purchase, but there's only 1 unit available, so the buyers start to compete to get the 1 available unit by offering more money. Price goes up, and consequently, quantity demanded drops and quantity supply rises until we get to equilibrium. What about a higher price, like $5? At $5, sellers are happy providing 5 units, but buyers are unhappy. They only want 1 unit. When the quantity demanded is less than the quantity supplied, we have a surplus and price will drop. Okay, let's go back to the housing market example. Price P1 is the stable market equilibrium price for this market. What if it's not the price? Start by taking a look at the Phoenix housing market in 2005 as an example. At that time, the price was below the equilibrium price. What happens at price 2005? There are lots of buyers at this price, the quantity demanded, not so many sellers, quantity supplied. This was characterized by homes being snatched up off the market, often sight unseen, often within hours of being listed, sometimes as the for sale sign was going up. New home developments were holding lotteries to determine which buyers would be allowed to purchase. Shortages result in increasing market prices, leading to an increase in the quantity supplied and a decrease in the quantity demanded. When will the prices stop rising? When there's no more pressure, no more shortage. In short, the market stabilizes at P1. Now, fast forward 3 years to observe the Phoenix housing market in 2008. In 2008, prices were greater than the market equilibrium prices. What happens at P2008? There are lots of sellers, quantity supplied, not so many buyers, quantity demanded. This was characterized by homes sitting on the market for months, some for over a year, even with remodeling and upgrades and in pristine condition. Some sat for so long that the owner simply abandoned them. This is a signal that the prices need to come down in order to increase the quantity demanded and decrease the quantity supplied. When will the price stop falling? When the surplus goes away, the downward pressure eases. This means that when the quantity supplied equals the quantity demanded at P1, the market stabilizes. So P1, Q1 must be the market equilibrium price and quantity. If that's so, how do we ever see sustained, stable price changes? P1 and Q1 are the equilibrium price and quantity for this particular set of market conditions, but supply and demand can change, and if they do, you'll get a new equilibrium for the new set of market conditions. Time to think. What happens to the equilibrium price and quantity if demand increases? What if demand decreases? What if your supply increases? What if your supply decreases? While you're thinking about these questions, try to come up with specific examples. What is the market and why would demand increase? Next time, price floors and price ceilings.